in terms of homophobia in jazz, I assume that because jazz, like many sports, is a circle of dudes, that there's always going to be some element of homophobia or fear or concern. The irony is that in this day, in this time, where I would say 75% or more of the musicians who are in this industry working, if we can call it an industry, are college-educated folk, are much more sophisticated than people in the past, and that this America has changed so much, and the issues of various folks, and particularly gay folks, have been put on television and in our lives. The notion that people can't talk about their sexual orientation, or they can't present that in their work, or that there's some other undisclosed issues that are brewing within that community is actually shocking, but not surprising. It's disappointing because it shouldn't really matter.
Stay with me, my passion. Thank you. alone together. Beyond the crowd, above the world, we're not too proud to cling together. We're strong as long as we're together. Alone together. The blinding rain has stopped this night. We're not in vain falling together. And what's there to feel together?
Thank you. Midnight train to Georgia. but a grand piano swinging heap of looping locomotions, traveling, spinning, relaxing on the axis of the wheels of life. Next stop, Harlem.
Thank you. Gender. I don't really think that way. I think, you know, some of the most sensitive musicians that ever lived, like Claude Debussy, I mean, the guy was a big old masculine slob, you know, big burly guy with a beard, smoked small cigars, you know, but he wrote the most, the sounds of the most feminine, beautiful, sensitive music, you know. So I, and then I know, you know, lots of women that are powerhouses. You know, there's a piano player that I've played with. I did a tour of Japan with her, Chihiro Yamanaka. She's a little thing. She's like 5'2". She plays like McCoy Tyner, like, her hands up here and like whacking the piano. You know, and I don't think music has a gender. I really don't. I you know, look at the way symphony orchestras now audition, and they have to do this legally. I mean, in that the musician that's auditioning to get win a spot in the orchestra has to play behind a curtain so they can't see what gender that person is or what color they are or what, you know, anything that could be considered a prejudice. And nobody really can tell that that's a woman playing behind the curtain or a guy playing behind the curtain. It's just music. You know, I don't think music has a gender.